Hello everyone, welcome to StressHSE. In our today video, we are going to see about hazard identification and risk assessment, which is called as HIRA, a step-by-step guide by StressHSE. Why hazard identification and risk assessment is much important. Hazard identification and risk assessment is a legal requirement and it ensures the safety of employees by ensuring correct safety measures are in workplace. Following four things should be taken into account. That means people, premises, plants, procedures. In HIRA, hazard identification and risk assessment, there are two parts. One is hazard identification and risk assessment. Before we are getting into the topic deeply, we need to understand what is hazard identification and what is risk assessment clearly. What is hazard identification? It's a simple part of the process used to evaluate if any particular situation, thing or item may have the potential to cause harm. That means if there is any object or a situation is going on to harm the people or worker working over there. And if you are identified that particular object or situation or that thing which is going to cause harm, that is called hazard identification. And then, what is risk assessment? A risk assessment is a combined effort of identifying and analyzing potential events that may negatively impact individuals, assets, and/or the environment and making judgments on the tolerability of the risk on the basis of risk analysis. Let me break that definition of risk assessment very simple to understand. Risk assessment is a simple procedure to find out the potential risk associated with the hazards which are identified earlier, and also to evaluate the severity of those potential risks which has been found and to take respective control measures, and also to evaluate the efficiency and effectiveness of those control measures. I hope now we got a clear understanding on hazard identification and risk assessment. Let's do a risk assessment together. Before getting into that, we need to understand some basic elements in risk assessment, such as like hazard, what is risk, what is probability, what is severity. We already saw earlier, a hazard is anything that may cause harm. Maybe it's maybe an object or it may be a situation which can cause harm is called a hazard. Then what is risk? Risk is the chance of somebody being harmed by the hazard. That means risk is the chance of somebody being harmed by the hazard. Risk and hazard is not same. Hazard is something which can cause harm. Risk is the chance of getting harm. And what is probability or likelihood? Probability or likelihood, both are nearly same. That means probability or likelihood is the number of chances that person or somebody can get harm. That means if the probability or likelihood increases, risk is increased. And let's see what is severity. That means it's a result or impact after getting contacted with the hazard. Risk assessments have 5 steps to be followed. Those are identifying the hazard. Second, decide who might be harmed and how. Third, evaluate the risk and decide on precautions. Fourth, record your findings and implement them. Fifth, review your assessment and update if necessary. Now I hope we got a clear understanding on the basics of hazard identification and risk assessment. Let's do a hazard identification and risk assessment for a simple scenario together. In the previous scenario, wet floor is the hazard and the risk is chances of falling on the same level due to the slippery surface. Here we found out the hazard and the potential risk. Now we need to evaluate the risk. For that, we are going to use a risk matrix. Now, here we are going to use a 6x6 risk matrix. In the previous scenario, there is a wet floor which can make a person fall down and there is no indication board. So, make the probability as 2. And if that worker came over that wet floor, he may got fell down because of the slippery surface. So, keep this severity or consequence as 2. So, the risk ratio is probability or likelihood into severity or consequence. So the corresponding risk ratio is probability into severity. That means 2 into 2 is equal to 4. This is our potential risk ratio. After evaluating risk matrix, we need to go through the control measures. And when you go to the control measures, for the previous scenario, we can put on housekeeper to clean that wet floor so we can eliminate the slippery surface. After ensuring the control measures, again we need to go through the risk matrix to evaluate the residual risk ratio. Now we don't have a wet floor, After taking control measures, now we don't have a bed flow. So there is no chances of falling down over slippery surface. So again, assume the probability or likelihood as 1. And now he is not going to injure in any case because he is not going to fall down. So again, assume severity as 1.
Now 1 into 1 is equal to 1. That's our residual risk ratio.
Now you may got a question why we need to evaluate the potential risk and residual risk ratio. See this following HIRAD augment. Here you can clearly understand both of these hazards having different potential risk ratios.
While you are making arrangement for the control measures, you should give priority for the assessment which having high potential risk ratio. And finally, the time scale to ensure the control measures should be in a reasonable manner. And this hazard identification and risk assessment should be reviewed frequently to ensure that the control measures are in place and adequate. If you found this video very useful for you, kindly like, share and subscribe. And see you on another video. Until that, signing off. Bye bye. Winston Luca.